Alright, what is going on, guys? It is SSN Santa here coming at you with a brand new video, and today we're going to be taking a look at the best class setup for the CS-LR4, guys. This is the brand new bolt action sniper rifle that Lucas Wilde added to Bullet Force, guys. I'm super excited to be making this video, guys, because for the longest time now, we've only had the M40A5 and the M200. Both of them are really good bolt action sniper rifles, and now we have a new one to add to the mix. So now we have three altogether. So this one is a higher fire rate bolt action sniper rifle. It only has 6 bullets per magazine, which is kind of low. And then you're going to have only 18 bullets left over. So you basically altogether, you only have 24 bullets. And that's not really a lot of ammo. So I have this really good class setup that can help you out, guys, getting more ammo and just having a better class setup using this gun. So first off, guys, for the perks, what I definitely recommend, the first one that's pretty important is going to be loaded, guys. Now, I wouldn't use this for a normal sniping class setup, but for the CS, I like to use this because you start with more ammunition, guys. So instead of 6 out of 18, you have 6 out of 27. Now, you think 9 bullets wouldn't be a lot, but it really is because basically, for the most part, this gun's like a two-shot kill far range, and you have to get 4 kills in order to get ammo back, and a lot of times I actually miss because the fire rate is like so high and I'm not really used to it yet. But when you're up close, you definitely do get like one-shot kills and stuff like that. But like when you're running low on ammo, like sometimes it takes me, like I'll get down to 3 out of 6 bullets when I've only gotten up to 4 kills, and it doesn't really help me. So using loaded is definitely a really good perk to use for this weapon. The next one I like to use is optimized, guys, because basically you're gonna be able to reload quicker. You know, having that really fast fire, you're running out of ammo really quick, has a pretty lengthy reload animation. So I definitely use this just to speed up that process. And then finally, I just like to use FMJ because I believe that it makes the bullets a little bit stronger, guys. You can penetrate a lot better, so getting collaterals, you'll get more damage there. You'll get a little bit more damage through the walls, so that will definitely help you out, guys, for better, one-shot kills or just getting more health off of people so your team can take them out. Now, I do have a couple tips. Like, when you guys are, like, trying to spawn trap, you're kind of far away. What I usually like to do is if there's, like, 3 people, I'll shoot one, and then if he's not really paying attention, I'll shoot another one as if I got a kill, but I didn't, then I'll shoot another one, because that means if your team takes the rest of the kill out, like, it takes, like, a lot of their health away. If they get the rest of the kill, that counts as a kill because you get an assisted kill, and because you have, like, over 90% or something like that, you definitely get to have the kill there. But, you know, sometimes I do take them out with 2 shots, but most of the time, I just allow my team to kind of clean it up and then give me the kill there. Now, moving on to the secondary, guys, I like to use the Shorty SG. Now, in my main gameplay, I'm actually playing the sniper event, so I'm not really using this, but when I'm not playing the sniper event, I definitely recommend the Shorty SG, which you guys know is the shotgun, the little mini shotgun you can get for your secondary weapon. It's definitely very good to have with this because when you're up close and you're running out of ammo, guys, you need to be able to whip out something that has a lot of damage and has like a good spread of damage. And I just like using the Shorty. It's better than having like a pistol. You get 3 tries to get out a couple kills, and it's actually a lot more fun to use, so I definitely recommend using that. And then I also like to use the flashbangs for the throwables, guys, because this is kind of like a rushing sniper, sort of like the M40A5 when I would use the flashbangs for that. Basically, the flashbangs, I would use those around corners, throw them up in the air, so that way I can blind an entire like group of enemies, rush in, and get a lot of kills there. It definitely is really effective. And finally, guys, one of the most important things is going to be the kill streaks, guys. Now, the first and the third don't really matter, but the second one you guys definitely have to have is Super Soldier. But basically, guys, Super Soldier is going to allow you to have one-shot kills with your sniper rifle. Your bullets are going to turn blue, which indicates that you have more damage, and this is going to last for 30 seconds. And the best thing about this is that getting up to 13 kills, it's really difficult because you're double tapping people, which means you're shooting them twice to kill them. Some of them you're getting one shots, some of them you're hit markering and you're getting assisted kills. So now you finally get to go in with the most damage possible using Super Soldier and getting one shot kills, guys. It's a great feeling. It's definitely fun. It switches it up a bit because you can finally use it for a weapon that's kind of weak and make it a one shot kill. But overall, guys, this is going to wrap up today's video. If you did enjoy, guys, drop a like, comment down below any questions you have for me, and if you're new to my channel, guys, subscribe, and I will see you all in the next one. Peace out.